Hello and welcome, dear students. Today we are going to begin with the literature topic Glimpses of India, and there are three subtopics in that. The first one is A Baker from Goa. It is from your NCERT published textbook First Flight and the CBSE prescribed book for grade 10. It is lesson number 7. Before we begin, I request you to write down the learning objective, that is to identify the main idea and details, and get ready with your KWL chart, that is what I know, what I want to know, and what I have learned. Proceeding further, it's a prose and it's a description of a traditional baker in Goa. It is a pen portrait, that means describe a person, we are describing a person in our language, the person is from traditional Goan village, the baker, and he represents certain resemblances of the Portuguese who left India long time back. But we still have important places in the society. The baker still has a certain important place in our society. Now, before we begin, let us get some idea about the lesson. What is it all about? The baker is from Goa and revolves around the relevance of a baker in the Goan culture, which dates back to the time when Portuguese ruled over the city of Goa. You know that it was one of the principalities of Portuguese. The Portuguese may have left, but the bread makers continue to have an inevitable stature. That means a grand place in the society. In this story, the author recalls his childhood days and their excitement on seeing the baker. So now it is a reflection of the child, how he used to welcome the baker and what all delicacies he used to enjoy during his childhood. The children, they were enthusiastic to the point that they would run to him as soon as they woke up without even brushing their teeth. So this was the peak of excitement within the children. This is the central idea and the total idea that we have in our lesson. The summary that we have is that lesson begins with how the narrator's elders often recall the time when Goa was under the rule of the Portuguese. So this is more of reflection and then the presence, then again reflection, then the presence. So you should be able to track the time. They talk how the importance of bakers is still maintained in their villages even after the Portuguese have left. So the semblance is still there, that means the culture and the tradition of the Portuguese is evident in the personality of the baker. In Goa, they are known by the traditional name, that means the padders in Goa. The mixers, the molders, these are the machines that they have, and their time-tested furnaces continue to serve the people of Goa of their famous bread loaves. Now you might be aware of that the olden times of furnaces are just a brick laid kind of a small compartment which is lit with coal, and that the bricks get heated up and those loaves, the buns, the bread was kept inside those furnaces to bake. It is nothing to do, it is no semblance, it has no resemblance to the modern machinery. It is impossible that the original ones may not exist, but their profession is being continued by their sons. So it is ancestral, that it is continuing in their family. The thud of the bamboo stick, thud means the hitting of the bamboo stick, can still be heard in some parts of the village. That means when the baker used to come around, he used to knock with the stick on the floor, on the ground, and that was the call that the baker is around, you can come and buy. The same jingling thud would make the narrator and his friends during their childhood days, who would go running to him without brushing or washing their mouth properly. It was the maidservant of the house who collected the loaves. Loaves are the long breads, loaves. While children sorted out the bread bangles for themselves. That means they played with the bread. Bakery products have importance in the culture and traditions of Goa. So it is one of the culture that means when they have certain festivals, they make bread. They have for example, for Christmas, cake is made, for weddings, certain things are made, for breakfast, the different things are made. So it is a traditional or cultural food over there. Bowl, that means the dough that is mixed, or the sweet bread is a part of the marriage gifts. The cakes and the bolinias or coconut cookies are eaten at every festival, and the lady of the house prepares sandwiches at her daughter's engagement. So these are the three places, please make a note of it because we have questions pertaining to it. One is bol, that is the sweet bread made for marriages. The bolinas are the coconut cookies, and the sandwiches are made for engagements and small parties. Earlier, bakers wore a unique frock, a knee length known as kabai. Make a note of this outfit also. But during the narrator's childhood days, they wore a shirt and trousers of length slightly shorter than the usual ones. So this is a comparison to be established with what the grandparents used to recall and recollect and narrate, and what the child, the narrator is trying to recall and recollect. Draw a comparison of how the traditional outfit has changed. Then generally collected their bills at the end of every month. That means the baker came around, so gave the bread to all the children or the maid servant who collected the bread. And at the end of the month, they used to collect the money in the village. This is very similar to that of the washerman who comes around, the milkman who comes around. They used to collect their monthly sales from at the end of the month. Bakery has continued to be a profitable profession, managing to keep their families joyous and prosperous. So it has continued in the family. Now let us go through the textual explanation of the text that we have in our textbook, and the explanation of the difficult words will be explained accordingly. And students are expected to make a note of the difficult words or the new words that they come across, and even jot down certain bullet points that will help them in writing the answers, or remember the citations for quoting while writing the answers. We begin with the original text. Our elders are often heard reminiscing means remembering and recalling. Nostalgic is also recalling recollection of certain past with great fondness. About those good old Portuguese days, the Portuguese and their famous loaves of bread. Those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the makers are still there. We still have amongst us the mixers, the molders, and those who bake the loaves. That means the people who do that, their speciality, they still have, they pass down their skills in the family. Those age-old time-tested furnaces still exist. I explained that those time-tested means just like the oven in the brick-laid or the stone-laid furnaces. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. Extinguished means put out. The thud or the noise made with a huge knocking of something, and the jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo heralding means calling out his arrival in the morning, can still be heard in some places. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. So it passed on from generation to generation. These bakers are even today known as padders in Goa. The meaning of reminiscing and nostalgically thinking fondly of the past. Loaves are the bread which is shaped in longer and single pieces. Vanished means disappeared. Molders, a person who molds the dough and shapes furnaces. I have explained that it is made with brick and stone, and it runs high temperature for cooking or baking the bread. Extinguished means to put out the fire. Heralding means announcing or calling out. Padder is a traditional word used in Portuguese for the baker. This is the explanation that I have just explained. Students may explain in their own words. You can make a note of it. During the childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend, companion and guide. He used to come at least twice a day, once when he set out in the morning on his selling round, and then again when he returned after emptying his huge bucket. The jingling thud of the bamboo woke us up from sleep, and we ran to meet and greet him. Why was it so? Was it for the love of the loaf? Not at all. The loaves were bought by some Peskine or Bestine, the maidservants of the house. These are the technical terms used for the maidservants. What we longed for were those bread bangles, which we chose carefully. Sometimes it was sweet bread of special make. Companion, a person who would make spread bread, sometimes jingling the sound made by the metallic ringing of the bell. Explanation of the text. The baker made his musical entry on the scene by the jang jang. That means the sound. You can make out this onomatopoeic word from of his specially made bamboo staff. One hand supported the basket of his hand, and the other banged the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with good morning, and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. Wickets would be pushed aside by the mild rebuke. Rebuke means a little shouting or threatening, or to move aside. Rebuke, and the loaves would be delivered to the servant. But we would not give up. We would climb a bench on the parapet and peep into the basket. Somehow I can still recall the typical furnace of those loaves of the elders, and the bangles for the children. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouth properly. And why should we? Who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? So this is in olden times that was used for brushing the teeth. And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. Look at the explanation the children are giving. Hot tea could wash and clean up everything so nicely after all. That's quite amusing and a hilarious way of mentioning that not to brush the teeth. Staff is a stick. It is also used by shepherds. Rebuke is a little expression of scoldings. Furnace is fragrance is for the smell. Parapet is a railing. Bangles made with bread. Continuing with the text, marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweetbread known as the bowl. Just as the party or the feast loses its charm without bread, not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for a village. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasions of her daughter's engagement. Cake and berliners are a must for Christmas as well as the festival. Thus, the presence of the baker's furnace in the village is absolutely essential. Make a note of all the events where the bread was served. Feast is a large meal. And the coconut cookies as bulinas. The baker and bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as kabai. It is known as a single piece, long frock reaching down to the knees. In our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and trousers. This was slightly different to the past dress that the bakers used to wear, which were shorter than the full-length ones and longer than the half pants. Even today, anyone can wear a half pant which reaches just below the knees, invites the comments that he is dressed as a padder or dressed up as a baker. This is in a hilarious way. Is giving a reference to the dress-up of the bakers. Bakers were known, this is explanation of the kabai, and the baker usually collected his bills at the end of the month. Monthly accounts used to be recorded on some wall in pencil. You can make a note of it that in village, all the billing on the recording or accounting is done on the wall. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days. The baker and his family never starved. He and his family and his servants always looked happy and prosperous. Their plump physique was an open testimony of this. That means they were healthy, they were well eating, the people that were, they used to receive good food for eating. Even today, any person with a jackfruit-like physical appearance is easily compared to a baker. Plump physique means me quite healthy looking, pleasantly fat looking. Instead of using the word fat, they use the word plump physique. Open testimony means an evidence or a statement of quality and character that he was well fed and he made good money from his profession. Now moving on to the question and answers. What are the elders in Goa nostalgic about? They were nostalgic about the traditional bakers of the past who lived during the times of the Portuguese. They used to ponder, rethink about them and the legacy of the bread making that they left behind. Students may pause and record the answers, but it is expected that in the first line students mention that it is taken from the Glimpses of India, the Baker of Goa. इज ब्रेड मेकिंग स्टिल पॉपुलर इन गोवा? हाउ डू यू नो? येस, ब्रेड मेकिंग इज स्टिल पॉपुलर इन द सिटी ऑफ गोवा. इट इज एविडेंट फ्रॉम द एग्जिस्टेंस ऑफ टाइम टेस्टेड फर्नेसेस, मिक्सर्स एंड मोल्डर्स. द लेगेसी ऑफ बेकर्स इज बीइंग कंटिन्यूड बाय द सन्स. यू विल फाइंड अ बेकरी इन एवरी गोवन विलेज और एज ब्रेड इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट ऑफ अ गोवन कल्चर. अगेन, द बिगनिंग लाइन इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू बी रिटन बाय द स्टूडेंट्स. What is the baker called? The traditional word for the baker in the Goan language is the padar. When would the baker come every day? Why did the children run to meet him? It was the morning and when he finished his daily chores of selling. The baker would come twice a day during the narrator's childhood days, once in the morning to deliver the loaves of bread and secondly in the evening on his return after selling his stock. The children would go running to him and take the special bread bangles he had made for them. So this was some attraction for the children. This exercise with regard to I had pointed out to make a note of it. When bread is made, match it and write it, whether for marriage gifts, parties, engagements or for Christmas, what is made. The information is given. For marriages, it is sweets, sweet bread called bowl. For a party, it is called a bread. For engagement, it is sandwiches. And for Christmas, cake and bolinas are made. What did the baker wear during the times of the Portuguese and when the author was young? The two different explanations are given, that in the previous days when of the forefathers, grandparents recalled and recollected that the baker wore a Portuguese style knee-length frock which was known as cabai, and in the narrator's time he used to wear a little shorter shirt which was slightly longer than and a little shorter than usual pants. Who invites the come in? He is dressed like a padar. Why? During the narrator's childhood days, the bakers had a peculiar dress. They wore shirts and shorter than usual pants. And thus, if someone is seen wearing pants of his much length, of this much length, they would invite the comment, he is dressed like a padar. Where were the monthly accounts of the baker recorded? Those were recorded on the wall with a pencil. What does the jackfruit-like appearance mean? Jackfruit-like appearance means quite plump and healthy looking. Jackfruit-like appearance means a well-built or plump physique. Similar to a jackfruit. In those days, bakers had plump physique. Physique means body build, because baking was a profitable profession. His family and servants never starved and were prosperous. Which of these statements are correct? The padar was an important person in the village. Yes, it's true. Padar still exists in Goan villages. Yes, it is true. The padars went away with the Portuguese. No, it is false. They still exist in Goan villages. The padars continue to wear a single piece long frock. That is false. They wear shirts and trousers that are shorter than the usual ones and longer than the half pants. Bread and cakes were an integral part of Goan's life in the olden days. Bread and cakes were an integral part of the Goan life in olden days. False. They are still an integral part of the Goan life. So it is not only in olden days, it is continuing. So please understand the context. What is given over there, the comparative statement, and then write the answer. Traditional bread baking is still a very profitable business. Yes, it is true. Padars and their families starve in the present times. False. It is still a very profitable business and many and their families are happy and prosperous. Prosperous means earning well and living well with healthy lifestyle. Is bread an important part of Goan life? How do you know this? Bread is an important part of the Goan culture and is evident from the presence or that every important occasion has some kind of bread or the bakery stuff in their gatherings and their parties. For example, for marriages they have got certain sweet breads. For engagements they have got sandwiches. For known as and they have got for Christmas they have got certain sweets. The bakers prepare something for every occasion. Take the right answer. What is the tone of the author when he says the following? The thud and the jingle of the traditional baker's bamboo can still be heard in some places. It is nostalgic. The choice is given. It is nostalgic in nature. The answers are given at the end of the exercise. Maybe the father is not alive, but the son still carries on the family profession. Choose, select whether it is nostalgic, hopeful or sad. It is definitely not sad. I still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. It is nostalgic, hopeful, or naughty. You can definitely make out he's recalling, recollecting. The tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea would wash the and clean up everything so nicely. After all, it is naughty, angry, or funny. It is a combination. You can see you might be stuck between naughty and funny, but look at the punctuation marks, you will know the right answer. Cake and bolinas are a must for Christmas as well as the festival. Whether it is sad, hopeful, or matter of fact, it is a matter of fact. Baker and his family never starved. They always looked happy and prosperous. Matter of fact, hopeful or sad, it is a matter of fact. With this, we have come to the end of this lesson. I hope the students will be able to write the question answers and do the exercise in their notebook. If you are new on the channel, kindly subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell so that you receive the notification when I upload my next video. And students are requested to hit like so that it gets added up in their playlist of like videos. You can refer these videos near test and examination. Thank you very much, students, for your precious time.